It's Michelle here from Lab Muffin Beauty Science, and today I'm going to go all hot and cold on you. Have you heard that putting beauty products in the fridge will make them last longer? Why does cooling products down make them go off slower? Why not put them in the freezer? Can you make them too cold? Let's have a look at the science behind what happens when you cool down a beauty product. If you own skincare and makeup products, you'll probably have had one or two go off at some point. Sometimes it's really obvious. It might change color, it might have a funny texture, it might have a weird smell, it might even have a spot or two of mold in the corner. Sometimes it's a lot less obvious, and you only know because you try it on and it causes you to break out or have a rash. And then there are some products that never seem to go off, like petroleum jelly or a jar of clay powder. So what's actually happening when a product goes off? The answer is usually chemical reactions. Most of the time when a product goes off, it's because the ingredients are changing. While on the surface it seems like nothing is actually happening when you look at it, if you look microscopically, if you zoom into the atoms and molecules, you'll see lots of little changes happening. At any temperature above absolute zero or minus 273 degrees Celsius or minus 460 degrees Fahrenheit if you're a heathen, everything is vibrating with energy. When you heat something up, all the microscopic particles vibrate faster. For a chemical reaction to happen, what needs to happen at the microscopic level is that chemical bonds need to break. This way, the atoms can rearrange and turn into new molecules. If there's a chemical reaction that involves more than one molecule, the molecules need to hit each other hard enough that the bonds will break. If they don't hit each other hard enough, then the molecules will just bounce apart without reacting. In your beauty product, you don't want reactions to happen. If you have a product with vitamin C or ascorbic acid, for example, you want it to still be ascorbic acid when you put it on your face. If you heat up the molecules, then they're vibrating more and moving faster, which means when they hit each other, they'll hit each other harder and more reactions will happen faster. It's a bit like two people bumping into each other. If they're walking, they'll probably just bounce apart without getting injured. But if they're running, then there's a good chance they might break a bone or two. Now imagine that instead of just having two people, we have millions of people walking around bumping into each other. Most of them will probably bounce apart without getting hurt. But every once in a while, someone might lose balance and fall over and break a bone, or someone might bump into someone in a weird way and jar their finger. If we wait long enough, eventually everyone will get injured. Now let's make everyone jog. Again, most people will bounce apart and not get hurt, but this time, injuries are going to be more likely. There'll also be more collisions because everyone covers more space in the same time. So everyone again eventually gets injured, but it happens a lot faster. Now, let's make everyone sprint. Most collisions will cause injuries, and everyone covers a lot more ground, so we get a lot more collisions as well. It probably won't take much time for everyone to get injured. It's exactly the same with ingredients in your products. Instead of people, we have molecules, and we make them move faster by heating them up. By the same logic, we can make the molecules move slower by cooling it down, and that's where your fridge comes in. There are a few reactions that don't involve collisions, but it'll still work almost the same way. Decomposition reactions, where a molecule falls apart, also speed up at higher temperatures. If you have, say, a Lego statue and you shake it harder, it'll break faster. Even when your product grows bacteria or mold, it's again because of chemical reactions. Every living thing is powered by chemical reactions, including humans. With bacteria and mold, it can be a bit more complex as well. Most organisms have a temperature range in which they function the best, and if you go outside of that range, like by cooling it down, then they don't function as well, they don't multiply as quickly, and so your product will go off slower. One way that products can go off without chemical reactions is when the texture changes. Most beauty products are emulsions, which look a bit like this. For example, they might have droplets of oil sitting in water with surfactants in between to hold it in place. Now, as you probably know, oil and water don't like each other, and this type of emulsion forces the two to come into contact with each other quite a lot. They'd much rather be apart. The surfactants help them hang out for longer, but eventually they want to break free and separate, like oil and vinegar in a vinaigrette salad dressing. If it's at a higher temperature, then there's more heat, everything moves around more, so the molecules will have more energy to break free of the emulsion structure and ends up separating faster. So if putting your products in the fridge will make them go off slower, why not put them in the freezer? Well, a lot of the time, freezing products will actually be better for these reactions and slow them down more. But it's those tricky emulsions again. Freezers are cold enough to freeze water. They're below 0 degrees Celsius. If you've ever made ice cubes, then you'll know that water expands when it freezes into ice. And this expansion happens when you cool it down relatively slowly in your domestic freezer. Water molecules also like to come together when water freezes. This means that a lot of the time when you freeze a product and then defrost it, where the water is located will change. For example, if you have a product that contains some whole plant cells, the water will hulk out and burst the cells, giving you a mushy texture. This happens with things like fresh face masks and lots of fruit and vegetables as well. More importantly for beauty products, it's those pesky emulsions again. What happens is, when water freezes, it freezes from one side of the product to the other. The expanding ice squeezes the oil droplets together, and this makes the emulsions separate. So when you defrost it, it won't have the same texture. You might have experienced something similar if you've ever drunken a frozen bottle of drink before it defrosted completely. It starts off super sweet because all the sugar and flavours have come together, but at the end, you're left with a bland block of ice. There's a cool video from a recent science paper that used confocal microscopy to see what happens when an emulsion gets frozen slowly. If you freeze a product fast enough, this isn't an issue because the droplets don't have time to come together and the ice doesn't have time to expand as much. This is why frozen food from the supermarket usually ends up less mushy when you defrost it than food that you've frozen yourself. It's also why liquid nitrogen ice cream ends up so smooth. It's because it's got tiny crystals because the crystals haven't had time to expand. But this isn't really possible with the temperatures in your home freezer. The other issue when you freeze a product and move the water around is that you can also change how well the preservative system works. If the original product was formulated properly, there would be effective levels of preservative throughout the whole product. But if the water is moving around, there'll be some areas where there's more preservative and some areas where there's less preservative. And the areas where there's less preservative can become underpreserved, which means that bacteria and mold can grow more easily. If you don't mind the texture change, and you mostly just care about keeping the active ingredients intact, and you only defrost enough that you can use quickly before mold and bacteria start growing, then freezing your products is fine. For example, it takes me ages to use up a tub of Lush's Angels on Bare Skin scrub, but it goes off after a few months. So what I do is I freeze it in little lumps that I can use up within a few days, and so I defrost one lump at a time. Each lump goes off after about a week, and it becomes super runny instead of nice and solid, but it doesn't make too much of a difference when I'm using it. On the other hand, if there's a product where the texture is really important, then you probably don't want to freeze it. For example, the microscopic emulsion structure of a sunscreen is crucial to how well a sunscreen works. Freezing it is going to mess up the structure and change the concentration of the sunscreen ingredients in the different parts of the sunscreen. Foundation is another example where texture is super important to how well it applies on your skin. So again, you probably don't want to freeze it. There are also some products that contain proteins called enzymes, and in some cases, enzymes can become denatured when you freeze them. And this is where the enzyme changes shape, and so it stops working. But the ones most commonly found in skincare products, bromelain from pineapple, papain from papaya, aren't affected much by freezing, so that's fine. That's all from me today about freezing your beauty products. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you liked it, then please like and subscribe to my channel. You can also follow me on Instagram and Facebook. I also have a blog where I have tons and tons and tons of articles on beauty science. See you next time for more beauty and science.